Yes, a very pleasant good morning, though it is very humid and hot. So today we have, started the topic active and passive voice. So before we initiate with the rules and all, first let's see why active and passive. Why is there such kind of topic in our language? Language, I mean, not only English. It's there in Hindi, it's in Punjabi, it's in French, it's in German. In every language, there are voices, active and passive voices are there. It's a way to say something. Why is there this kind of, thing like active voice and passive voice? So where is the need for this? We have to first understand this. I've written two sentences, the rules were broken and disturbance was caused. Or if I say, people broke the rules and it caused disturbance. Do you think there is some difference in both of the sentences as far as meaning is concerned? Meaning-wise, is there any difference? Meaning-wise, both of the sentences are same. Are you sure? Meaning is same, hai na? There, here I talked about here people are there, but there was no mention of people. Therein lies a difference. Okay, you say, ma'am, meaning wise, no difference. Yeah, in the end, the point is like disturbance was caused. Disturbance is the limelight. That's the issue. Because of the disturbance, we are talking about this issue. Now, the thing is, like, what is important? Of course, disturbance is important. Suppose I am a newsbreaker. Suppose I'm a news reader. For me, what is more important? Is it important for me to say that the disturbance was there? Or is it important for me to say that people did that? What is important? Disturbance, what is important for me as a news reader to tell? Or is it important for me to say people did that?
Disturbance.
Who are people? Anyone. Maybe I am there in the people. Maybe you are there. Who are people? You don't know. So here subject is not important. Action is important. The action is when disturbance was caused. Okay, what happened? What is told in the news? The news is about the happenings. The news is about the actions. News is about what happened. Of course, afterwards, it's about who did. Gold medal was won. Is it enough? Will you like this news? Gold medal was won. Gold medal has been won. Then you will say, ma'am, who won? Now, all of you would be eager to know the name now. So Neeraj Chopra is more important than just merely saying gold medal has been won. So Neeraj Chopra clinches gold medal at Olympics. Is that a better headline or gold medal at Olympics in the pocket of India? Neeraj Chopra clinches a gold medal. That is more important. So the point is, if I say gold medal has been won by India, is that more important or India wins a gold medal? India wins a gold medal. Neeraj Chopra wins a gold medal. So where the names are important, Lavanya? The names are important. For me right now, Lavanya is more important. Instead of saying, lecture is not listened by somebody. If I say lecture is not, lecture is listened by some, is listened by somebody. That's not important. But if I say Lavanya is attentively listening to the lecture, that would be better. No? So that is where the difference is. What I mean is, when you want to focus the doer, when Neeraj Chopra is important, then Neeraj Chopra clinches a medal. So what is it, active or passive? Active. Neeraj Chopra clinches a medal. Active or passive?
Active.
Yes? Active. But when I say a gold medal has been won by India, passive. And you know what is better? Neeraj Chopra is better. Active form is more important. So if I say as a newsreader, gold medal has been won, then people will throw tomatoes upon the channel. They won't like it. Like, who won? India or Neeraj Chopra? What? So India and Neeraj Chopra, that is, the subject is important. So when we want the subject to be highlighted, we use active. Note down. When we want the subject, that is the doer. Subject is a doer, not a deer. When the subject or the doer is important, then what is used? Then active form is used. Active voice. When subject is important. Subject means the one who is doing the work. Neeraj Chopra won the medal. Neeraj Chopra's winning. Neeraj Chopra's subject is important. Right? But when the work or the action is more important. So the second point is, first is when subject or the doer is important, then active. But when the action is important, action or work, then passive voice. Right? Note down, whenever you are being taught something, always be habitual of noting down. Yes. Now in these two sentences, tell me in the first sentence, what is there? Subject is prominent or action is important? The rules were broken. Action is important. What was the action? Breaking of the rule. And then causing of the disturbance. So here action is there. So in these sentences, action, because my focus is upon like what happened, you know, rules were broken and disturbance was caused. Then when I want to focus upon the action or the work, then passive voice is used. I've used passive voice here. But when I want to say, you know what people did there? They broke all rules. People broke the rules. And all that caused disturbance. So subject, what caused disturbance? People caused disturbance. So here I want to complain about the people, those who were there. So when I want to focus upon the subject, then I have to use active voice. So here it is the work. Sorry, it's the subject. So that's why active voice. It's your choice. Many a times you might have observed that you, in our daily routine, we many a times use active or passive unknowingly. It's not that then we realize, like, what's the rule of active, what's the rule of passive? Because whenever we have to say something where action is more important, then without realizing, we use passive voice. Can you give me some examples? where you use active and passive voice unintentionally. Unknowingly, you use active and passive voice. Even small kids use it. They don't know what active and passive voice is. Can you give me some examples? Yes. How do you say? Give example. Don't give me situation. Give example. Ma'am, Harshit is making noise. And also here, Harshit is more important for you to tell. Because if you say like, ma'am, noise is there, noise is made, then teacher might scold all of you. But you don't want to be scolded. You want only Harshit to be scolded. So ma'am, Harshit is making noise. Okay? But when you want to hide the name, then what do you say? Someone is making noise. Then someone is not very important. Ma'am, the disturbance is coming. Then you say, ma'am, disturbance is coming. So point is, you are basically talking about the passive voice, like disturbance is being made by somebody, but you're not pointing out somebody. Right? Can you give me some more examples where you use active and passive unintentionally? Somebody broke the glass. Is it active or passive?
Active.
It's active. Okay.
The glass was broken by somebody.
I am asking you, like, some by chance, you people use passive or active voice. Give me those examples. Right now, don't try to think I am making active, I'm making passive. I want to say that whatever is in our grammar, those topics have not just come there to make you people confused or to make you people burdensome. They are already there. You've been using them right from your childhood. When you were 1 year old, then you used certain things in passive voice. But at the time, you did not know that they are passive or active. Yes? Nobody is. What is it? Is it passive? Nobody is. Nobody is important. Ma'am, nobody is. Nobody is important. So that is active. Okay, when teacher says students keep quiet, is it active? Whenever you say something in active or in passive, there has to be a transitive verb. What's a transitive verb? Where the action transits from verb to object. She broke a glass. She broke. Broke is a transitive verb. Breaking of what? She broke what? Glass. So she broke a glass is, here broke is transitive verb. That's why there is a case of active or passive voice. But when I say children keep quiet, it's not a case of active or passive, because here, keep quiet. Keep is not a transitive verb. Keep what? Don't tell me, ma'am, quiet. Quiet is an adverb. Okay, so transitive and intransitive verbs you people did in 5th standard, in 6th standard, in 7th standard, in 8th standard. Now in 9th standard, we are just revising these things. But even then, I'm telling you, transitive verb is a verb where the action transits from the verb to the object. For example, if I say, she eats ice cream. Eats what? Ice cream. So ice cream is an object and eats is a transitive verb. But if I say, children fly kites. What is fly? Fly is a verb. Transitive or intransitive? Transitive, because fly what? Kites. Birds fly in the sky. Fly is? Birds fly in the sky. Fly. What is fly? Think and speak. Birds fly in the sky. What is fly? Ask fly the question what? Birds fly in the sky, right? Fly what? So no answer is coming in the object. So birds fly in the sky. Here fly is intransitive. But when I say children fly kites, then fly what? Kites. Then that is transitive. So if you want to change the voice, you need to have the transitive verbs there. If transitive verbs are not there, active and passive voices are not possible. Okay, that is also a precondition. Right? So we were talking about active and passive voice, like certain sentences which we speak unintentionally, but they happen to be sometimes active or sometimes passive. Okay, many are times they are active. For example, you were saying, ma'am, no one was there. No one opened the door. And it's active. Or when you say, door was not opened. Passive. Ma'am, I went there. I covered about a distance of about 20 kilometers. And when I reached there, the door was not opened. So what do you mean by this? The door was not open means, for you, the most important thing to tell is that you were so much unwelcomed that even door was not opened. Okay, so it's a passive voice. So many a times we say something, many things like this. Food is not ready. When you say, when you reach home, mama has not made food. She has gone to attend a kitty or she has gone to see a movie. Then you say, food is not made. Very bad. Food is not made is what? Passive. Because for you people, food is more important than anything else. This time, it's not important whether mama made it or not. Food is not there. Food is not made. Very bad. Okay, but when you have to fight with your mother, then you say, mama didn't make food. Active, passive, se aage bhi jao. Okay? Mama didn't make food. You are there to fight with your mother. Okay? Okay, so let's start with the active and passive. Active is the one where we focus upon the speaker, subject. Subject, that is a doer. Passive is when we focus upon the action. The Prime Minister flagged off a new train. Prime Minister flagged off a new train from Metro Delhi, from Metro Station or wherever. The Prime Minister flags off a new train. So here, what is more important? That the Prime Minister did the inauguration. But if I say, a new train launches from Metro Delhi, here the inauguration of the new train is more important. Supposing I went and did the inauguration, then the newsreader will not say that Renu Sharma inaugurated the train. She will say the train, new train was launched. Okay, then name will not be important. But if the Prime Minister does it, then you cannot ignore Prime Minister. Prime Minister's name has to be, officially it has to be there. If something is done by Prime Minister or President of India, because they happen to be the topmost chairs of the country, so they represent the whole country. So their name would come first. Okay, the principal addressed the gathering. Or you will say gathering was addressed. What is correct? The principal addressed the gathering, because in the school, the topmost chair is principal. Without principal, you cannot say, anyone cannot address the gathering. Even if the principal did not address the gathering, but even then you have to mention it somewhere in the report. The principal, Mrs. XYZ, addressed the gathering. Is that clear? So that is a respect given to the designation. So that is where we have to be very careful about whether to use active or passive. You cannot say that, supposing you're writing a report on Independence Day celebrations, and there you say in the end, somewhere in the beginning, the flag was hoisted. Will you write this? The flag was hoisted. You tell, beta. The flag was hoisted. Is it okay? Why is it wrong? Yes, the flag was not hoisted by any Tom, Dick or Harry. It's not that anyone was asked and to hoist the flag. The topmost chair of the school will do this. And right now we have principal. And if the management is there, then our Maharaji will do this. Whosoever is at the highest designation, that person is supposed to do it, and that person's name and designation should come there. You cannot say that the flag was hoisted. The point is, the principal, Mrs. Kamaljeet Kaur, hoisted the tricolor. Got it? So what I want to tell you is, like, narration, active and passive voice are there. Of course, when I ask you to change the voice, then you will change it for the heck of it. But the point is that why are you learning these things? You are learning these things to use them correctly at the right time, at the right place. When you're writing a report, then you should know which sentence is to be written in active and which sentence is to be written in passive. Okay? When you say report in the report again, title, will you write the title SSTPS celebrates Republic Day or Republic Day celebrated? Republic Day celebrated by CBS, SSDPS. What is better? Very good. What's your name? Gaurav. So he has picked, you all have picked up the right, I guess, point. The point is, where the name of the institution is required, then that is to be written. If I say SSDPS celebrates Republic Day, if I ask you, okay, better change its voice. Very easily you will change that Independence Day was celebrated SSDPS or is celebrated. You will do it. That's not an issue. But the point is how you use it at the correct time, place. But when you're about to write a report, then if you write Republic Day celebrated, Republic Day celebrations, finish. SSTPS celebrates Republic Day. That should be the title. So title is to be here in active form. Okay. And yes, one thing more. Yes. Let me tell you. If I say better report title should be SSTPS celebrates Independence Day. Here the name of the school has come. And name of the event has also come. But when you make it passive in the title, if you write it like Republic Day celebrations in SSDPS, it is neither active nor passive. That is also okay. But when you make it passive, Republic Day celebrated by SSDPS. Yes? Yeah, you can. There is no hard and fast rule. This is what I am saying right now. If I say SSDPS celebrates Republic Day or Independence Day, SSDPS celebrates Independence Day, active. Or I say Independence Day celebrated by SSDPS, one and the same thing. But the better is active. SSDPS celebrates Republic Day. Because name of the institute is also very important. Yes?
The title always should be inactive.
Title should always be inactive. It depends upon the kind of title it is. It depends upon the title. But yes, when you're writing a report for the on behalf of institute, then your name should come first. Then try to write it in active, preferably. But again, I'm telling you, it depends upon the kind of topic it is. Okay, for example, the title is Violence Erupted in JNK. You will not say terrorists caused disturbance in JNK. That is active. That's not required. So violence erupted in JNK because it was erupted by somebody else. So you have to decide whether it should be, what is more important. Yes. Can you please repeat?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, of course. If I say the glass was broken, the glass was broken, then when you have to change its voice, what will you do first? First, you will add object there. The glass was broken by Gaurav. Okay. So what it will become? Gaurav broke the glass. So you cannot make active without the subject with you. Without subject active, not possible. Okay. But in the passive, subject has become object, and that is implied. When I say Gaurav broke a glass, the glass was broken. Full stop. Though I am not saying by Gaurav, but it is implied that by is somebody. But for me, the name is not important there. Is that clear? When I say like somebody switched off the fan. Okay. It here somebody is there. Somebody switched off the fan. The fan is switched off. But children, fan is switched off. What I want to say, that fan is switched off, switch it on. I don't want to point out like who switched it off. That is immaterial. Got it? So in such a long lecture today, we just it's not introduction, it's complete. Rules you know by default. This is where the usage comes. The end product, the end of a grammar topic is using it. When you are not able to use the grammar in your write-ups, in your speech, no use of grammar. Grammar is not to be learned to know that, to say that I know grammar. Grammar is to be learned so that you are proficient in write-ups, so that you are good in speaking. Is that clear? So that you know how to use language correctly. Okay, many people learn grammar, know grammar, so that you get marks. Okay, from examination point of view, you should get marks. But in the end, the purpose of grammar is to be a proficient linguist. That's it. What's the use when you don't know how to write a good report? How to give a report? How to write a good story? How to speak up the right things? Okay, so purpose of grammar is to become a smart speaker, smart writer, smart listener. Okay, try to put grammar in the usage. It was not introduction, it was complete concept of active and passive voice. Okay, so one only line is required about active and passive voice. That is, when we change active into passive, listen, when we change active into passive, then only the form changes. Only form changes. Tense remains the same. I say, I teach 9C. Active. But when I make it passive, 9th C is taught by me. So nothing has changed. Only what has happened? Only the focus from subject to action has changed. When I say I teach 9C, then I am important. But when I say 9th C is taught, then it means that teaching to 9C is more important than I am. Otherwise, meaning is same. Tense does not change. Only form changes. Is that clear? When you put water in a glass, or when you put water in your bottle, only the form, only the shape of water has changed. The essence, it is same. Same is about active and passive. So it's a complete lecture on active and passive. It was not introduction. But still, for you people's satisfaction, we will do the rules. Okay? Because you people will feel ki ma'am ne rules bataye nahi. But rule is, tense doesn't change. Present remains present. And past remains past. Future remains future. Okay.